Hi, I'm Frank Arkwright, Mastering Engineer at Abbey Road.
My name is Geoff Pesche, I'm one of the Senior Mastering Engineers here at Abbey Road. Been here since 2006, what a lovely place to work.
Hi, I'm Alex Gordon and I'm a Mastering Engineer here at Abbey Road Studios.
What we're trying to do is we're trying to optimise the sound for each track, make it sound brilliant, and then get a good sonic flow between all the tracks that go together on an album or an EP. We have the ability to make things bigger, fatter, brighter, louder. It's pretty much essential if you want a commercial release, unless, you know, you're very good at doing it yourself. We will add some sonic excellence to it.
It's the final QC, really, the final check, the final tonal balance changes before any format, record, CD or download is available to buy. In the digital age now, where people are making things in the box at home, they rarely visit what we would call a studio back in the day. So to come here and have a final QC in a room like this with acoustic treatment and somebody with a lot of listening experience glossing over the record, saying it's good, bad, happy or sad, very important.
So mastering is the final part of the production process. It's basically finishing people's music and getting it ready for commercial release. When it leaves our room, that should be it should be finished. I mean, especially a lot of the time, if you're producing music yourself and you're mixing it yourself and you've written it all yourself, I think it's really invaluable to hand it over to someone else who's hearing it for the first time with fresh ears and is probably a bit more objective about it than you are if you've been slaving over it for weeks or months. Because otherwise it's a bit of a closed loop if you've just done everything yourself, because you've probably listened to the tracks, you know, about 1,000 times by that point, and you've kind of lost the sense of what sounds good or bad about it.
That's why the mixer doesn't master records and the masterer doesn't mix records. The mixer would be 6 hours mastering one track because he's never satisfied. The mastering guy would mix a track in one pass. He'd go, yep, done. Because we're two different animals. You know, we're very final. You have a record deadline today. It's got to be in the factory tomorrow, CD factory, whatever, digital provider. I need to get this done. So if the whole band are here having a row about it, I've got to referee it. I've got to say, look, this has to be out tomorrow. Universal missed the deadline. It's going to be your fault, but it's also going to be my fault. So let's crack on. That's what we do.
It's after the mixing, then it's the mastering, and that's it.